And now we will start the setup steps by putting in customers and vendors and learning how to edit their information. You need data on both customers and vendors. We know that customers are the people whom you sell your products and service to, and vendors are those who sell you products and services so you can run your business. It's good to have a Rolodex to access any of their information, but the most important reason to put in their information is that you need to choose their names from a list when making transactions with any particular customer or any particular vendor. Here is our customer data. This is not all the information that QuickBooks Online can hold. Obviously, I left out things like phone number, email address, and website. I just gave you a small sample of the data that you would put in, and you could always go back and edit the customer's data and add the extra information that we did not include. Now, here we are in QuickBooks Online, and the area of customer data is over here in sales. So one way to reach the customer area is to click sales, and then when you get the top bar across here, you can click customers. Now, if this is the very first time that you're coming to the customer screen after creating the company, it will look like this. And the only thing you can put in is the name, phone number, and email. I'm only going to put the name. Once you pass this first screen by putting in your first customer, you will never get this screen back, and you will go directly to the customer center. The first customer is Alan Arby, so I'm only going to put his name. I like to leave the cap lock on so that it's more clear. Now, I don't have his phone number or his email address. I'm just going to click Add Customer. Once I put one customer on the list, now you can see the customer center. Every customer you add will be put on this list, and it will go all the way down. And of course, you can edit the information about this customer just by clicking on it. So, let's go ahead and edit the first name that we put on the list. I click here, and here we are only in Alan Arby's information. Now, I can click Edit in the top right, and this screen comes up where I can add or change any of the pieces of information about any particular customer. First name Alan, last name Arby, and I believe the address was 111 First Street. And I don't think I gave anything after that. I guess I did New York, New York. And the zip code for Alan is 11111. Of course, if I had his phone number, I would put it here. If I had his website address or email, I would put that in. And I can always come back to the screen the same way I just came to the screen now to change any of Alan's permanent information. Click Save. And all of Alan's information, you can see his address or whatever else I put, is now saved. Of course, you can go back to the customer, you can click Customer Details, and you can see all of the fields of information that you put in, and you could always click Edit to change or delete any of that information. Let's click Sales and go back to the customer list and put in our next customer. Click New Customer. Now this customer is Betty Boop, and she lives in 2nd Street. Betty Boop. And Betty lives, Betty Boop lives 222 2nd Street, New York, New York, and her zip code is 22222. We can save Betty. And as you can see, you can confirm the details, and you can click Edit and change any of the details that you just put in. Let's go ahead and put in our third customer. See, now we have two customers on the customer list. Let's click customer, and the third one was Candy Charles. Oops, I put her first name and last name in the same field, but that's okay. You can always change anything at any time. And she lives on 333 3rd Street, and we'll be using her for transactions. So put it in just as I'm doing, and her zip code is 33333. Click save. Now we have the three customers on the list, but notice something. When you have a specific customer open, these are the details of the data you put in. And in the future, you will be making transactions with this customer. The great thing about QuickBooks is that you can click the transaction list for the currently selected customer, and you would see a list of all transactions that you made with that customer. The good news is that putting in and managing vendor data is exactly the same as putting in and managing customer data. Just like with customers, you click sales, customers. When you put in vendors, you will click expenses and then choose vendors. And again, if it's the first time that you're coming to the input vendor window, you will see this. But after you add your first vendor, you will never see this screen again. You will see the list of vendors that look similar to the list of customers. Okay, we'll put in Con Edison and Verizon. Then you can pause the video and put in Staples and UPS yourself. So we click Add a Vendor, and this screen looks very familiar, just like the customer information. And we'll put Con Edison here in New York. That's the electric company, and the address is 111 First Street. I guess they're right next to Allen. New York, New York, zip code 11111. Now look, after you click save, you go back to the vendor list, and you can see you have your first vendor on the list. To put the next vendor on the list, click new vendor, and we will put in Verizon. And I believe Verizon was 222 2nd Street. I guess they're right next to Betty. New York, New York, zip code 22222. Click save. And of course, if you want to change any of the vendor information, you would come here to the vendor list just like we showed. You would double click on their name, and then when you have their information in front of you, you would click edit. And then you could edit, add, change any of the permanent vendor information right here. Notice, again, when you click here, you get the details of the vendor information you put in. When you click here, you get a list of every transaction you had with that particular vendor. Now, because this is the first time you're putting information into QuickBooks Online, I'd like to give you a beginner's tip. If you're ever lost and you accidentally clicked in the wrong place, just click the back button in your browser. Until you get more comfortable with QuickBooks Online, that will return you to where you were. So if you clicked in the wrong place and you found yourself here, just click the back button in the top left of any browser. See, this was the window we were at before the window that I showed you. Now, if you want to see the window that you were at before that, click the top left, the back button. This is where we were before that. Click again. We were at the customer center, and so on. So this will help you if you accidentally click in the wrong place and you feel lost.